Hey, all right, welcome back. It's another Learn Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1378, Embed Excel in Your Blog. All right, well, hey, this is going to be a long podcast, and there's going to be a challenge at the end where you can win some cool stuff. I was out at Microsoft in February. Of course, the next version of Excel isn't out yet, but Excel web app, it's already gone through two or three releases since it originally debuted in July of 2010. And they introduced something very, very cool I have to show to you. If you're a blogger or if you maintain a website and you want to create some little calculator and embed that calculator in your blog or in your website, it's now very, very easy to do that. So I want to show you, I just built a simple little spreadsheet here a long time ago. I used to manage the bid desk for a company, and the sales manager would always say, hey, let's give them another 10% off, right? And I would just cringe because a 10% discount from list cuts into the gross profit dramatically. So I put that old bid desk hat on, and I created this little chart that shows people what's going on. And I want to embed this in my blog so that way I can just, you know, pull it up and show the sales manager. Now, I have some calculations here outside of the view. I don't want anyone to see that, so I'm going to name the range that I want to display. This is not required. I'll just call display this. So now I have a named range, right? This next part is just a little bit hokey. I need to get to a dialog box, and there's only one place that I've found. File, save and send, save to SharePoint. I don't have SharePoint, don't worry. Up here in the right-hand corner, publish options. I don't want to do the entire workbook. I want to do items in the workbook and display this. Click OK. Now notice I'm not saving to SharePoint, just changing that parameter. We'll come back here. We'll just do a regular old save. It's called price4.xlsx, and we'll close out of Excel. All right. Now let's go out to the web. On the web, you need to get a free account at SkyDrive.live.com. You can put up to 25 gigabytes of stuff up there, or I don't know, some huge amount. It's free. It's whatever. And I'm going to add files. Now, of course, if you're in Excel 2010, you could save directly to the SkyDrive. But let's assume you're in 2007 or even earlier. So we'll add files, and I'll go find that file. Select documents from your computer. To my documents, price4.xlsx, open. Alrighty, good. Continue. Alright, there it is. Now, hover. See that? Hover over here. More. Share. Now, this folder is already shared, so I didn't have to click on share, but you would have to. And then right here, the brand new code, embed. Look how hidden that is. No one would ever find it. I'm glad you're watching this podcast. And when I click embed, I'm going to get this code. All right, now this is the code that normally I would plug into my blog. But you're going to want to change this code a little bit. And they document that here at this link. Read this link. And I can even, I'm fairly sure that over the coming months, this page will get better. They'll allow you to do some of these things. So I'm going to copy that, and actually you could click here to copy. I never see that copy button. I think it should be right there, but hey, whatever. And I'm just going to come into Notepad and paste. Now, a couple of things we want to do, and I kind of have notes here from the last time that I did this. First off, you see where they say allow interactivity equals false. That needs to be true. And then you also need to add, if you want to allow them to type, this ampersand allow typing equals true. And then the width and the height, my blog allows up to about 600 across, so I'm going to make this have a width of 550, less chance of a scroll bar appearing then. And height, again, I'm not really sure, I'm just going to make it really tall, maybe like 900. And I can do a little bit of experimenting with that. All right, now hey, you know, one tip, if you're not the person posting this in the blog or on the website, don't just copy this and paste it into an email. It's going to get screwed up. They're going to encode some of those characters. Save it in a text file from Notepad. Send the text file to the person and let them copy and paste. But here we'll try it. Control C. Come back to the web. Here's a blog post that I started. And we'll just paste right there. Now, hey, don't be alarmed. WordPress is going to change that word iframe to office or something like that. They're going to take the ampersands and change them to pound 038. They'll handle that, though. Don't worry about that. We can just take a quick look here. Actually, let's save a draft. And then preview. Just always check this out the first few times before, All right, so there's the intro text to my blog post. And then there is the spreadsheet. And let's see, I can come in here and say instead of giving them 10%, let's give them 20%. I can type, I press enter. The formulas recalculate, the chart redraws. All right, it's absolutely amazing. It requires no JavaScript, nothing, as long as you have the Excel know-how. And if you're watching this podcast, you have the Excel know-how to build a little spreadsheet and then put it out there in your blog. People can interact with it. The chart updates. You can use slicers in a pivot table. They can choose from the slicer. That's allow interactivity equals true. And just choose from the slicers and see the pivot table update. This is an amazing technology. Initially, the Excel web app was some tiny little subset of what you could do in real Excel. Well, now we have an example of something you can do in the Excel web app that you cannot do in regular Excel. You can't just use regular Excel to embed something in a web page. You know, the people using this, they don't need Excel. It's very, very cool. So, hey, here's my challenge. We haven't done a challenge of the month now in a couple of years. And so from now until about the middle of April, I want you to use some thought. What would be a cool application? What would be a cool little spreadsheet that you could build and embed in a blog or in a web page? And I want you to go out, build your little Excel spreadsheet, upload it to the SkyDrive, get the embed code, send the embed code into us, consult at MrExcel.com. We'll post it here in the blog, and then in a couple of weeks we'll take a look at the best ones. Suitable prize. We'll get you a plethora of books and CDs from the Mr. Excel store, and also bragging rights, of course. And then also, hey, we have another great challenge of the month coming up the second half of April. This one's sponsored by Microsoft with some really cool Microsoft toys available, so watch for that one. All right, so hey, there we have it, episode 1378, and a new challenge of the month, embedding an Excel spreadsheet blog web page. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.